Bobby. Thank you for being here. I'm Dan Cooney, I'm the artistic director, and I just wanted to welcome you and say thank you for being here. This is Jessica's fourth show. We had to add a show because of the sold-out performances, so how exciting. I did want to say hello to the dear Tony Walton and Jen Walton down here in front. If you've been living under a rock for the past 50 years, Tony has won numerous Tony Awards and Oscar Awards for his work on Broadway and in film. So thank you so much for making this work. And the brilliant Jen Walton as well. I want to say also thank you to Jan Lyons, our sponsor for the summer series, and to Michigan Radio for also sponsoring. And of course, the Bernard L. Moss Foundation, who named the space. We are sitting in the Moss, a very generous $500,000 gift to kick us off. So here we are. Thank you so much. Did I miss anything, Emily? Let's do this. This is my third time seeing Jess and Judy, and I'm just as thrilled today as I was Thursday night. It's absolutely brilliant. I'm not at all biased, of course, but thrilled to be here again. Take it away, good sir. Thank you.
Shouting her praise, that's Judy. again. What else could I do again but keep repeating through and through, I love you, love you. I still recall the thrill, I guess I always will. I hope 'twill never depart. Dear, with your lips to mine, arouse and divine.
Was my childhood idol, and we have some things in common, Judy and I. So we are both small town girls with big dreams. Judy was from Minnesota, I'm from Ohio, Midwest girls, right? But I was born in Michigan, so don't hate on me. And we live here now, yes! Judy performed with her family, and I also performed with my family. Oh, that's my headshot from when I was 10 years old. Judy and her sisters performed in an act called the Gum Sisters, and later when Judy changed her name to Judy Garland, they also changed their name to the Garland Sisters. And me, I performed in Columbus, Ohio, with my family, that's my brother and me, in a summer production of The Music Man. Oh, there's my father and I down there. Yeah, so we, that's what we did for fun in the summers. But Judy was the soundtrack of my childhood. I'm not exaggerating when I say that I spent countless hours up in my bedroom listening to the CDs that my mom bought for me and singing along and doing my very best to be like Judy.
Dear Miss Garland, I am writing this to you, and I hope that you will read it so you know. My heart beats like a hammer, and I stutter and I stammer every time I see you at the picture show. So maybe I'll shine. I'd love to see your name right beside mine. I can see we're in harmony. Looks like we both agree on what to do, and I like it. How about you?
Well, it's hard to think of Judy Garland without thinking of her old pal and co-star, Mickey Rooney. They did many, many films together over the years with MGM. And I had the good fortune, when I was a teenager, of getting to play the role that Judy played in the film, The Wizard of Oz, at New York City's Madison Square Garden. Now, this was a big enough thrill, but you can imagine how excited I was when I found out that none other than Mickey Rooney was going to be joining us and going on tour with the cast. So, right? It was pretty exciting. I think I just dribbled on myself. I'm a classy broad, Tyler. But anyway, so yes, it was truly, truly a joy to work with Mickey. And I'm going to sing a couple of songs from shows that movie musicals that Mickey and Judy did together. These are a couple of my favorites.
Our love affair was meant to be. Our love will smile.
feels so nice to be singing for all of you. Thank you for being here. So my all-time favorite movie growing up, and probably still is today, was Meet Me in St. Louis. Thank you, yes. And you know, I don't think I was alone, because it was the biggest grossing musical film of the 1940s, that entire decade. And it starred, of course, Judy Garland as Esther. And the film was directed by Vincent Minnelli, who later became Judy's husband, as well as father to their beautiful daughter, who is now very, very famous, Liza Minnelli. And Vincent was credited with giving Judy a role that was an adult role for a change. She'd only played children, pretty much. And he was also credited with giving her a whole new look, which really made her career take off in a different direction. So I used to spend countless hours trying to recreate that look up in my bedroom. I would try to do my hair with those. I didn't even have bangs, but I would try to create the bangs and put my hair long, wishing I was a strawberry blonde like her, and also wishing that there would be a boy next door that I could sing this song about. The moment I saw him smile, I knew he was just my style. My only regret is we never met, though I dream of him all the while. But he doesn't know
he took his hat.
may know this. Most of you probably don't know this. I didn't know this until I was doing some more research for the show. Tyler actually made me aware of it, so I'm not going to take full credit. But Judy Garland had an on-again, off-again, decades-long love affair with Johnny Mercer, who's a songwriter. And gosh, you know his songs. Old Black Magic called Love. The Maid.
Yeah.
What else, Tyler?
I guess I should have my mic
here. Louder. It's okay. No, so, but anyway, we're going to talk more about Johnny and Judy later. Johnny and Judy recorded this song, which was on one of my favorite albums growing up. And Tyler and I would like to share it with you. Tyler, you want to give it a go?
Let's do it.
All right.
All right.
If you're ever in a jam, here I am.
If you're ever in a mess, S-O-S.
If you ever feel so happy you landed jail on your bail.
It's friendship, friendship, just a perfect blendship. Without your friendships have been forgotten.
Ours will still be hot.
If you're ever up a tree, phone to me.
And if you're ever down a well, ring my bell.
If you ever lose your teeth when you're out to dine, borrow mine.
It's gross.
It's friendship, sorry, friendship. Just a perfect blendship. When other friendships have been forgotten,
ours will still be great.
A la 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 la, chuck chuck chuck.
If they ever blank your eyes, put me wise.
If they ever cook your goose, turn me loose.
If they ever put a bullet through your
It's friendship, friendship, just a perfect blendship. When other friendships have been forget,
ours will still be it. A little bottle, hep, hep, hep.
If you ever lose your mind, I'll be kind.
Thank you, Tyler. And if you ever lose your shirt, I'll be hurt.
If you were ever in a mill and get sawed in half, I won't laugh.
Gee, thanks.
It's friendship, friendship, just a perfect blendship. When other friendships are up the creek, ours will still be slick. A la la la, woof woof woof, a hen hen hen, a chuck chuck chuck, a ding ding ding. Good evening, friends.
Were in together called Girl Crazy, which later became a Broadway musical in the 90s called Crazy for You, which you may remember we did at the Encore in the old space just a couple of summers ago. And Tyler was our musical director for that.
Yeah.
So we're going to sing a couple songs from Crazy for You / Girl Crazy.
Just like a flipper. Each morning
the band. Mike, this is Mike. Mike. Yeah. Mike and Mike, this is Tyler. Tyler, Mike and Mike. Would you believe it? They just met today. It's incredible. But in all seriousness, we have our dear Tyler Driscoll on the keys. We have Mike Karug on the cello, but he slaps that thing like it's a bass. And we have the unparalleled Mike Morrison on the drum. I feel pretty lucky to get to sing with this group, this combo. So thanks, Tyler.
I'm lucky to be playing for you, Jess.
Thank you.
That was really a spit thing.
I know.
I didn't mean that to be funny.
I have to learn the art of drinking water delicately while bantering.
Maybe. We have plenty of time.
I was going to say, maybe by Sunday.
Drink more slowly.
I need a straw. So, so there's a movie, a film, a musical movie. I really
a movie musical?
That's it!
Those?
Tyler, a movie musical!
I love those. That's my favorite genre.
Why did I think of that? There's a movie musical called Easter Parade, which I'm sure many of you are familiar with. And this movie was 1948 and starred Judy Garland and Fred Astaire. Now, kind of a fun story about that is Fred Astaire was 2 years into his retirement. Gene Kelly was supposed to play the role that he played, but Gene Kelly broke his ankle playing volleyball. And so they called Fred Astaire, and with Gene Kelly's blessing, Fred Astaire took over the role. And which brought him out of retirement and revived his whole career. I just found that so interesting. So we got a little bit more Fred Astaire, thanks to Gene Kelly and his silly, silly volleyball game.
I still think you made that up. Surely it was polo or something more interesting.
No, it was volleyball.
Okay.
Yeah. But you know what, Tyler? Do you know what I love?
Aside from your water? I have a feeling you're going to tell us. Could you tell us in song?
Yeah, this is something I love more than anything.
Baby talk.
So in 1954, Judy starred in a film called A Star Is Born. And it was written by Harold Arlen, who wrote The Wizard of Oz music, and Ira Gershwin. Yes. And her performance of the song made it the 11th greatest song in American cinema history. And it also, her performance won her an Oscar nomination. But despite Judy's 5 marriages and substance abuse and ups and downs, Judy was always, it seems, searching for love.
The night is bitter, the stars have lost their glitter, the wind grows colder, and suddenly you're older, and all because of the man that got away. No more his eager call, the writings on the wall, the dreams you dream.
Their friends, Johnny Mercer's friends mostly begged them to call this off. They said, this is no good for anybody. Judy agreed, but it went on for decades, off and on. It was that one love. And he was the man that got away, I believe. We know that Johnny Mercer wrote, I Remember You, for Judy, not for her to sing, but it was about her. One great love, the one who made his dreams come true. Tyler, there's another song that's about Judy and Johnny. Will you tell us a little bit about that?
There are a few. I would be glad to. The song Jessica's referring to is This Time the Dream's on Me. Sad thing about Johnny Mercer in particular, because he achieved so much success and is really, I consider to be the poet laureate of the Great American Songbook. He always considered himself a failure because he never had that big Broadway hit. Saddling himself with a classic American musical always seemed to elude him, no matter what he did. And similarly, I think he was extremely aware that Judy Garland felt the same sense of failure and insecurity because she was stuck in the studio system as a child star and wasn't, you know, given the leading lady roles that were so coveted that went to the likes of her roommate, Lana Turner. I think Johnny was very much in touch with that and felt that himself. And this song in particular alludes to those feelings and also hints at a romance that could be, that could experience a reunion, but I think the subtext of the lyrics suggests that the person who's speaking knows that it's not possible, that it can't be attained. And that's a lyric to This Time the Dream's on Me.
And Tyler's gonna sing it for us.
Okay.
Channel your best Johnny Mercer.
I will do my best. My Southern charm. Somewhere, someday, we'll be close together, wait and see. Oh, by the way, this time the dream's on me. Adoringly, but as things stand, this time the dream's on me. It would be fun to be certain that I'm the one. Supply the shore you cry upon to see you through till you're everything you want to be. It can't be true, but this time the dream's on me. Thank you.
to be certain that I'm the one to know that I at least supply the shoulder you cry upon. To see everything you want to be, it can't be true, but this time the dream's on me.
Great art, but it is very sad.
Yeah. So, Johnny Mercer actually wrote this next song with Harold Arlen, who wrote Wizard of Oz score. And it was originally written for the Broadway musical St. Louis Woman.
Depends on where you're from.
St. Louis Woman.
As a river.
really fun medley is from the 1961 concert, famous concert, Judy Garland live at Carnegie Hall. And it's been coined the greatest night in showbiz history. So I'm gonna do my best to channel a little bit of Judy here and hopefully make you feel what it felt like to be at Carnegie Hall. It's a tall order though, so.
What a day this has been. What a rare mood I'm in. Why it's almost like being in love. There's a smile on my face for the whole human race. Why it's almost like being in love. All the music of life seems to be like a bell that is ringing for me. And from the way that I feel, when that bell starts to peal, I could swear I was falling. I could swear I was falling.
Sorrows, no sighs. This can't be love. I get no dizzy spells. My head's not in the sky. My heart can't stand still. Hear it beat. This is too sweet to be. Because I feel so well, and I love to love, glad I'm alive, love to live, think I'll survive, there's a smile on my face, for the whole human race, all the music of life seems to be like a search for a lasting love. You can hear it on her recording, how heart-wrenching and soulful this is. So this is It Never Was You. Searching through rain and the wind that follows after for one certain face and an unforgotten laughter. I've been following signs, I've been searching through the land for a certain pair of eyes and a certain pair of hands. Yes, I try to kiss here, and I try to kiss there, for when you're out in
sunset reminded me, or a flower hanging high on a tulip tree, or one red star hung low in the west, or a heartbreak call from a meadowlark's nest made me think.
So, I'm sure we all know what it feels like when you have to go do something and you don't feel like it, right? When you've had a bad day, but you still have to show up to work and put on a happy face. I experience that. You know, sometimes I'm not feeling well and you still have to get on stage and make everybody think that you're just perfect and fine. And I think, like, Judy Garland, gosh, she must have really, really felt so much pressure, you know, between growing up in that studio system where they gave her pills to wake her up and they gave her pills to put her to sleep and up and down and up and down, and it became an addiction for her. Very, very unfortunate situation. But, you know, the main point was that she would get on that stage and perform. And gosh, it brings new meaning to this song for me. Forget your troubles, come on, get happy. You better chase all your cares away. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day. This is
who had told you they would give the world for a toy. All I have are these arms to enfold you, and a love time can never destroy. If you're asking in return what I would want, dear, you'll be glad to know that my requests are small. Say it's me that you adore, for now and evermore. That's all.
We can't thank you enough. And I'd like to thank this amazing band, Tyler and Scoop. Orchestra at Carnegie Hall. I don't know how they do it, but I feel so lucky. I'd like to thank Alex, who's in the back on the projections, and Joe, my friend in Pittsburgh, who created the projections for me. And isn't it great? I love the projections. I'm so excited about them. And Meg over there on sound, and Jake up there on the lights. Thank you both so much. Husband and everybody here at the Encore for making this dream of mine that I didn't even know was a dream to like be on a stage singing Judy Garland's song, but making this dream of mine come true. It's pretty fun. As we know, Judy's life wasn't always rainbows. She had some ups and downs, and Mickey Rooney told me stories about the studio system and how it affected them and how it didn't work like it does today. They didn't get residuals for their films. Their children, their estates didn't get residuals. So Mickey Rooney was on the road with me at 85 years old, partially because I think he wanted to be, but mostly I think because he needed to be. As a mother who is entering my 40s, I just know how difficult that can be. And Judy passed away working in London, not because she wanted to be there away from her family doing a show, but because she needed to be. She needed to support them. And unfortunately, Judy died at the age of 47 in London, an untimely death. And
I'm always chasing rainbows, watching clouds drifting. Thank you. happy.